Bonjour, buenos días, buongiorno. In Dutch, sorry, I don't know. Thank you very much. I hope you understand my accent, but it's very mixed with different languages, and it's the first time that I present that in English. Okay. What about me? I am Giacomo Partipilo, and I'm joined PSA Group in 2001, and since 2007, I work in virtual and mixed reality for different professions and different use cases and proof of concept. For today, the agenda. For today, the agenda. Sorry, but the presentation don't move. No. Sorry. Normally, it's okay. That's all right. Okay, the agenda for today that I propose you is a little presentation of the PSA Group. Okay, to just for the people that don't know the group, presentation of the project vehicle PSA Global Process. How we start from the paper to go into the digital process today for different things. Presentation of a virtual reality solution that we use in different cases. The emergency of the mixed reality, where I specialize at this moment. And conclusion, and finally, briefly exchange if you have a question. We start with the PSA Group presentation. Sorry, I had a little problem with the clicker in the backstage. I am sorry, but that don't move. Yes, sorry, someone in the backstage, the presentation don't change the slide. Yeah, okay, thank you very much. PSA Group, we pass the next, please. And sorry, the technology is not matter reality, but it's real. Yeah, sorry, do you have? Yeah, okay, thanks. The presentation of the group. PSA Group is composed by five car brands, Peugeot, Citroën, DS. Recently, we bought Opel and Vauxhall, and one mobility brand, Free to Move. The figures for the 2070 years, PSA sold all around 3.2 million of vehicles all around the world, and we have close to 170,000 employees worldwide in different countries and continents, and we are the second European car maker. Just an introduction. If you can change the okay. Now the presentation of PSA Global Process for a project car in the automotive industry. Okay, you can change, please. Okay, it's just an image to show you the different processes and phases that we have to make a car. Okay, that starts with the definition of the programs. Okay, program of different vehicles, and we start with the white paper. Going to the definition of the style, the choice of the style, okay, is correspond to different things. For example, compose the team that work for the project, choice the steel and the different innovation that the project are embedded, and we just top the steel and the concept that the future car. We have to make. In the second phases is the project start, and that's going from the virtual to the manufacturing first vehicle series. It's a representative first vehicle in the plant. Okay, and for these different stages, the different teams simulate, calculate, and work with 3D and CAD models and different usage of digital content. At the end, the last big phases is from the manufacturer of the car to the trade after sales. Okay, it's a very, very important industry. It's very complex because there are a lot of professions that that work for the constitution and have a car at the end. Okay, in all this step, virtual reality, mixed reality, and different digital devices and processes, it's very important to us to share information and to help the different person and teams to take decision. Okay, and before to start to have a physical part, that the cost is very highly. We simulate a lot of things in with CAD and 3D information. Now I show you a little history from the evolution, from the paper conception, from to today with digital processes that we use. The above mentioned figure show many different changes that take place in the recent decades here in PSA. For example, you showed before the 70s a lot of conception and different definition of a car are based with paper, okay? Is the field photography in the corner left. And that's have an evolution with the personal computer more and more powerful. And today, for example, in the 70s and 80s, the 2D design, it's arrived with a personal computer. The designer and the conception and the personal team for calculation start to make different things with personal computer and a big server for calculation. In the 80s and 90s, CAD arrived with a different solution that permit the different teams and the people that decide the direction for a project to evaluate different configuration and different things. In the decades of 90s and in the 200, the computer vision system was improved, and we saw the emergency of the virtual reality for different use cases and for simulate different things, design, processes, manufacturing processes, ergonomics, and different studies. At PSA in 2004, at the site of Vélizy-Villacoublay near Paris. It's a design site and a study for different processes. We built the first cave for PSA at the virtual reality center. And it was equipped at that time with a visual and haptic solution. In 2007, we start, and I start, to have some simulation and to experiment a different solution with ER solution. We start with a lot of people here, with Metaio and AR Toolkit and different things, just to evaluate what is the 3D in the real environment improve, okay? And we have a lot of use case and proof of concept that we made from the that moment. In 2012, we start and we develop a solution based on optical see-through head-mounted display for the people that now we start with NVIS ST50. It's a very head-mounted place with a cable reliable to the computer and optical see-through and binocular. And that use that for different cases in the plant, and we put that with a tracking infrared system to have the movement, for example, for the trajectory, robot trajectory in the plant, to add help the operator to update the trajectory directly in the environment. that is very important because the people and the team, for example, study and simulate that in 3D. But 3D it's very good and it's excellent. But the reality, you have difference. You, for example, for the flexible ankle of the robot, you can simulate the flexible compartment because the movement that change every time. And for example, augmented reality in the plant permit to the operator manipulate the real robot, see, for example, the car before that the real car arrive in the line, and update the different point of passage of the robot and the trajectory to improve and have a big simulation in a real environment before the first car arrive in the line. The first car in the line is a very big change for the plant, okay? And if you stop the plant to produce the models that is in for the customers, it's a very cost for the company. And we use different cases of augmented reality with optical see-through head-mounted display, tablet, and different things. In 2014, we start with AR augmented reality projected directly on the glass. Okay, and if you are going in internet, you see the video for the first car that project information on the glass. And actually, we work in different solutions to training the people, all the customers that we ask. For example, if we have a sondage of how many people read the manual for the car to use the car, today there are not a lot of people that read the manual before to start the car. But the autonomous vehicle, the project actually in different automotive car maker, it's a big change for the comportment and to understand the comportment of the car in the different situation, okay? And augmented reality and virtual reality for training, it's a very good process to training all the customer and end customer. Why we use virtual augmented reality? Use that in order to reduce project cost, okay? Because it's very cost to produce physically a part and after change because it's no montable in the car, or because it's no good or the piece have a problem. And we use that to make the system reliable, the different system, okay, the IT system, and improve quality of the pieces that we make before to make that physically, and offer a wide range of options and customization. If you saw the evolution of the vehicles 40 years ago and today, you can choose different options, different steel, different colors, and different things, because 3D, it's easier to change different things in 3D, and after produce that on demand. Next slide, please. No, sorry. No. In the presentation. Sorry. I'm sorry. Yeah. Sorry. But clear. On the backstage, you can change the slide, please. Yeah.
We're working on it.
Yeah. Thank you, Patrice. I'm sorry. Okay. Thank you. As seen in the previous slide, PSI began using CAD computer aid and visualization system at scale 1 for the 80s. Okay, with the fast evolution of the different system and technologies, software and devices, we use different solutions in immersive VR. Okay, for a product, for example, to see the visibility and the concept of the cockpit for the person. For the process, process montability of the different parts, the ergonomics, different simulation depends of the profession and the needs of the different profession. In mixed reality, we have developed and testing different solutions for marketing for the product, for example, to marketing papers or to see different options and for the end customer. And for the process, to simulate have a vision of the change in the plant before the real car arrives in the plant. Because introduce, how I said before, for introduce a new car in the plant is very, very complicated, and we can't stop the line production just to evaluate the new fabrication and the new manufacturing of the car. And augmented reality permit us to evaluate the different change, the time to do that, and for the logistic cost that reduce because you have to treat confidentiality of the new prototypes, the time, all the people and the team that you move for different study. And with augmented reality, you can take a video, you can take a picture, and just evaluate that at the office. Okay. In rendering, we have a big calculating system that permits us to simulate real-time rendering. Okay, for different use. For example, for perceived quality before to make the real piece. And the measured rendering, just to be sure that for the painting, the color is respond on the same way that the light and the people see or the color, okay, perceive the color. And we have a different system of driving simulation with a dynamic simulator that permits the different team to evaluate the configuration of the wheels and the engine and different things. Okay, just for communicating, 360 degrees overview. For example, a use case is you can move internal in the plant, the different plant worldwide the world, and the person in the office can see and emerge with a head-mounted display in the plant, but see very, very, very far from the real plant, okay? Just to evaluate and imagine where is the environment, the real environment. Okay, I pass to the next. Oh, yes, thank you very much, backstage. It's okay. Virtual reality, okay, an overview. The Virtual Reality Center based on Vélizy, Villa Coublay near Paris, is equipped with different systems, okay, that of new generation of visualization for different things. And I show in this image the evolution of system that is very accelerated this last decade with the augmentation of the calculation system and the resolution. Okay, for example, you see in the first line the first generation of HoloBench that was made in 2002. It's composed with a two-screen system, and a speeder is for haptic solution. Okay, for simulation. Haptic solution is just to relate, for example, when you mount a 3D piece and it's in contact with another piece, you have the return information. And for example, for the people or conception people, can change the geometry of the piece, and we can simulate different things. Okay, but it's very important to simulate. In before the montability of the pieces before to make that. And in 2012, yes, we improve the system in the second generation to a hollow space with three screen and the full resolution. The same for the stroscopy screen in 2004. We passed in 2017, the last year, to a stereoscopic screen 4K Okay, it's for the study and the style study and design. And the cave was updated in 2015, for 5 screen system in 4K resolution, 4K resolution. And the dimension that's changed. And the last cave that we have at Vélizy, it's composed of the screen, okay? But we have sound, a special sound, okay? For example, to guide the team with the sound. For example, if you have if you take a manipulation here and you the part it's have a problem in the back, you can hear that the part is tap in another part in the back of you. And we have a haptic system integrated in the cave, okay, with a virtuous haptic arm. Main uses of virtual reality for the product design, we use that for perceive the quality and the style of different pieces, for example, for the cockpit, and to study the cockpit architecture for different homologation and different systems. For example, they verify the visibility in the cockpit, okay, depend of the form of the pillar, the accessibility to different things, and for the human-machine interfaces to evaluate and simulate the comportment and different things. And the process design that permits to the team to evaluate the montability of the piece, the accessibility, the ergonomics, and for example, to simulate the accessibility for the painting parts. In progress, in virtual reality, some progress because it's a very large solution that evaluates. But now we evaluate new head-mounted displays and elaboration of related methodologies because that changed for the before methodologies. When you use a cave, it's not the same use when you put a head-mounted display to the team. Okay. So a different team needs to have the methodologies concerned to this device and peripherics. For the real-time physical bus rendering, for example, if you see that, it's just image synthesis, digital image, and we permit the different things to perceive the geometry and the car and evaluate in the night environment and the light scene, okay? Because all the automotive car, we work with to identify the signature of the lighting. And visualization of vehicle in motion for marketing purpose of different things. Now, I told you about mixed reality at PSA, and that's my real work from since 2007. In this way, the last decade has been the emergency of different reality, augmented reality and mixed reality solution. I work in this way since 2006 to evaluate different systems, different techniques, and different devices. How do you say? An automotive industry, it's very, very complex industry with a lot of profession, and every profession have their needs. But when you use augmented reality solution, you need to adapt the solution to the profession, okay? And for example, professional perhaps saw that in the internet, yes, I want to make head-mounted displays, but you take a lot of time to develop and to have a solution, a scenario, content that don't have a real things for the profession. It's you spend a lot of time and a lot of money. Okay, it's very cost. And in this way, we evaluate different solutions at the start with a market-based imagine a solution from Metallo and other things, infrared system to just it's we need that for attach 3D models to the mobile physical part. It's how I talked before. For example, if you have a real robot and you simulate the projection of the painting on the car, but the cone of the painting is just a digital, you can evaluate the distance what the robot need to have from the car. And today, the unique solution to do that is to have an infrared tracking. Okay, IR solution today they are not improved to have a no marker solution. We use model based for different things for evaluate. For example, there is in engine and to see and for training, spatial mapping and SLAM. With the operation of HoloLens and other things with a tablet. And in the car, directly in the car, geolocation directly with a head-mounted, head-up display directly on the glass. But augmented reality is not only visual reality, okay? Visual information. Augmented reality, we work in different multimodal systems. Because what is augmented reality? You need that to have information to take the decision. And the decision you can take for visual, but by sound, but vibrating, system vibrating, haptics, and smell, for example. And the copy car with the different system of advanced driving assistant system, there are systems that augmented the reality for the driver. Okay. And we work in different systems for that, for the future in the autonomous car, because when the driver don't move, don't take the wheel, it's need to have information very quickly to return to the driving position. Okay. Just augmented reality from design and engineering department. To use in the field, some use cases, for example, HUD, okay? Mixed model copied architecture for evaluate different steel and parts in a not completed real part. And for the sale after sale, to propose to the customers to visualize the different options and different things that they can make and that physically don't present in the showroom. And for process, we use that for training, for painting simulation, and help operator system, for quality control, or user assistance. And now a real deployment is for training, okay? It's very, very interesting for that, because the other things is so complicated in the plant. In the progress, today we have to automize the system, the IT system, to pass from the design to use and dissemination for all the people. Often the problem with CAD that it's authoring software. It's very hard for the devices like a head-mounted display or tablet, and we need to solve and to reduce different number of polygons to use that in little devices. And it's a very big problem that costs a lot of time to pass from the design and authoring software to the end user. And in progress, the evaluation of different ER devices, visual, acoustic, haptic, etc., and elaboration of related methodologies to different professions. In conclusion, VR and AR are complementary technologies, okay? That depends of the needs and the people that you respond for his need. The maturity of devices and software solutions remain quite so different, okay? Virtual reality is no augmented reality, but you can use different thing in different ways, the different proposition. Different use for different needs. Different acquisition and maintenance cost, okay? The cost from a cave is not the same that for a head-mounted display for VR, and it's not the same for the ER because it's more recently. And ease of use and deployment to adapt to according to the target user. Okay, you understand that. All depend of the what do you need for what. More complicated to ensure compatibility for a mobile solution. It's due to the operating system devices on different things. In improvement in VR, okay, it's resolution. For example, you see we evaluated that with visual acuity comparison by system. Head-mounted display is they have not the same resolution that a cave today. Okay, to evaluate, it's normally because the head-mounted display is just here, and in the cave you have different. The diff is not the same. Quickly in the AR improvement, we need hands-free and optical C3 wireless head-mounted displays is good for us. But we need to improve field of view, size and weight, battery autonomy, resolution, 3D models, number of polygons that we can use, contrast and brightness for exterior use, and the cost, reduce the cost. In digital content and use case and simulation software, automation process for authoring software to the end user solution, the conservation of the texture and rendering information between different software, accuracy when you put virtual and real overlay, and the association of 3D object to physical and tracking mobile object in real life, cost and time produced to content AR. For AR purpose. That's all for me. I think it was interesting for you. And if you have any question.
You ready?
Yes.
Giacomo.
Thank you, Patrice.
Muchas gracias. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Merci beaucoup.
De nada.
Do you have any access to like some old-timer Citroën DS? Just asking for a friend, not really.
No.
You do? Okay. Yeah. Let's talk about that later. Let's go through some questions from the audience. Why are HUDs still so small today? How long until large windshield HUDs become available?
It's a very good question. It's so complicated because the projection of an image in the glass, okay, it's in the windshield. It depends of the weather, okay, the luminosity of the ambient and the volume in the cockpit, the volume to project, okay. If you project an image like that size, you need to have a very big distance from the projector to the surface where you project. In a vehicle, the distance is not very grand.
Pardon?
Il n'y a pas beaucoup de distance.
Not enough space?
Yes, not enough space. And the volume to have the projector is very complicated. And we have solution with reflection on the mirror, okay? That you can reduce the distance for projection to have a big image. But it's so complicated because the cockpit, you have a lot of things under the cockpit.
But don't you think that one day maybe like the entire screen will become also an HUD head-up display for that matter?
Not at this moment, perhaps in the future, but not at this moment.
But then again, it will be a security issue if you have anything going on the windshield.
Yes, we work in that because we saw that screen on the vehicles. We have a lot of screen in the vehicles today. Okay, but they have a lot of problems that we are studying. For example, if the thickness the motion sickness.
Right.
If you read when you move, your hair and your vision don't have the same information, and for the people, some people is no good. And to see your screen, you don't have the accommodation with the reality. For example, okay. If you see a screen in the pillar and you see the real way, you don't have the same information, visual information.
All right. Going to the next one. Has PSA considered AR, VR as a tool to help customers make decisions in the sale process? I think so, yes.
Yes, yes. It's a good question. And we have in the showrooms for sales different applications that the people and end consumer can take decision on option on different things, different style of the cockpit and the chair, different things. Okay. That's one.
Ah, again, like a finance question, of course. Do you calculate the return of investment for VR implementations?
Yes, but I don't have the numbers. Sorry. Because it's not my domain. I work in a ER solution, and it's very now it's a last decade that we evaluate different things and different ways. In VR, it's another team.
Okay, I hope that we get this one right. Is PSA developing this internally amongst the many use cases you mentioned, which has gained maximum traction?
Okay, it's a good question. Before 10 years ago, we developed and we have a team that developed different solutions internally, but a car maker is not an editor of software. And the decision is to work with different companies and people that develop a very, very interesting software quickly. And we specify our needs and work together with them to develop a different solution.
Okay. Guess what? There's a little part, again, that goes towards finance. But the main part is having new technologies in your VRC is great, but how many employees on the manufacturing shop floor are using them on their daily basis? What about your return of investment?
Yes, the new technologies is very expensive, okay? If you start to evaluate the new solution, for example, for AR solution, if you, an example, you can buy an HoloLens, okay, it's a little expensive, and for example, you put that for the people that just see holographic in a stage, it's okay, but the return of an investment is so complicated to evaluate because they can see that with a tablet or different things. But if you take the solution to have a hand-free solution to visualize and to cooperate and have a collaborative solution, it can have a ROI that is more important, and you can collaborate with, for example, a team in Paris, with a team in Brazil, and on another place in the world. I hope that responds the question, but it's so complicated for one use case.
Going to the next one, how are you tackling the automation of 3D content generation?
It's so complicated because
I kind of expected that answer already.
Yeah,
okay,
yes, we work on that. They are a solution now that just working in this way. Us at PSA, we have a Dassault system solution for the conception. It's CATIA, okay? And we pass actually for two or three software to simplify the CADs, okay? Texturing the CADs to have a real rendering of the part. And after, we use another solution to put that in the different devices. And but it's not an automated chain. Actually, it's manually. But we work with IT teams to have that. And we use for a change, just quickly, we use CATIA, Sometimes we pass by Pixis. Pixis is a solution for a French company. And after we work with DeltaGen, RTT DeltaGen that was bought by Dassault Systèmes 2 years ago. And after we put that in Unity and after in the different devices.
Okay, then grazie mille, merci beaucoup.
Prego.
Dankeschön, Giacomo. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, Giacomo Partipio.
Thank you. Bye.